Hello everybody and welcome back to the last part of this weekend's semi-final Oshkosh World Cup 2016. We have two more exciting matches for you today. The first will be Argentina versus Indonesia. I'm Debbie and with me today will be Arf and Juan Crystal. How are you guys?
I'm doing fantastic. Hey Arf.
Yeah, I'm doing good too. How about you, Debbie?
I'm actually really excited for these last two matchups, because as I just said, we've got this one, Argentina versus Indonesia, and then afterwards we've actually got Germany versus United States, so we've got some pretty good matches coming up. Should be good.
You know what is good? I think Indonesia is in Asia, right?
Southeast Asia, really.
Okay, so yep. We have one from Asia, one from Europe, one from North America, and one from South America in the winner's bracket. That is cool.
Yeah, that's a diversity you don't really get a lot in some of the more popular World Cups out there. Although this year, of course, I do see a lot more viewers in our Oshkosh listing. So it's nice to see the equal participation there. Or as close as you can get to equal anyway.
Yep, it should be quite good. So, talked about, so that's rude. What do you guys think about this matchup? Are you going to go for Argentina, thinking Indonesia?
It's really difficult to say, isn't it? I mean, that's just what makes this match that much more exciting, because even though you don't really see Valparque on Argentina's side right now, he is waiting in the wings. For everybody out there, it's really difficult to call, with the math pool being what it is.
I will say, like, it's going to be hard for me to commentate this match. Like, Argentinian people are really passionate, and it's hard for us to, like, forget a little bit that we always think that our team is the best. It's hard for us, but in my honest opinion, I will say that this is a pretty equal matchup. I will say that Indonesia has probably a lot more hype in their shoulders, I will say. They already fought in really hard battles between really hard teams, so they already know how this works. And they are definitely up for the challenge. Deceitful is the first one that comes to mind here for Indonesia, being probably the man of the match most of the times. But it's not only that, they have Dragon, they have Galaxy, Solar Beam, they have a lot of good players. And for Argentina, you can see that they also had a lot of hype in their hands, because they have Belperk, they have Force, they have a really decent roster. Now I see Dante, which is a player that I didn't see too much lately, mostly for the hidden thing that Argentina really needs. Red's probably going to be there for the Hard Rocks. So it's like every single team has a lot of potential in different modes of like Hard Rock and Hidden. But the thing about these two teams that I think is edging a little bit in favor of Indonesia is that Indonesia has... Oh, well, the map just end because every single player for Argentina failed, if I can tell correctly. But I was saying that Indonesia has like a little bit more chances in order to put three people able to perform well in a single mod. That is something that Argentina cannot really do that well as Indonesia. So I will call Indonesia being the team that has more advantage here in this matchup. I'm not calling that they will be the winners, but they definitely have the upper hand for me.
I can definitely see where you're coming from with that. In terms of well-rounded squads, Indonesia, I'd say, like you said, does have a bit of an upper hand on Argentina, but despite the score V2 in this tournament, we have seen that a single player can make a lot of difference in the outcome of a match. So I wouldn't count Argentina out just yet. They've got some really able squad members on their end as well. Definitely not to be sneezed at. That said, the first warm-up did end a little bit abruptly, but we will be moving into the second one, and oh boy, what a warm-up this is.
D-Dragon looking for me.
Well, there's a lot of blaming going on.
He's like, what hippie, where are you?
Alright, so second warm-up is ready for this time. It's going to be Road of Resistance. And this is a map by Force, which is the Argentinian captain. As you can tell for the difficulty name, Force CTV.
Yep, this was definitely mapped by Force himself. It's not the auto-convert on standard that most of the chat will probably be familiar with. Nonetheless, knowing the song, and it does go at quite high velocity, I'm really interested to see how he mapped it. This is probably not going to be an easy 5 minutes, if they even make it that far. That last warm-up didn't quite go all the way.
Well, I don't remember Force mapping this kind of stuff, like last 5 minutes. Something like Furioso Melodia or stuff like that. I won't call Force like a great mapper, but that's probably the main thing here, right? Because if you cannot map something really, really flowish in Cash the V, you usually tend to fail it. So I can see a fail here from any team.
Just a bit of self-promotion there from Force. I don't see the issue. Given the song, it's probably really good for warming up on, though.
I actually remember, wasn't it like a really hard standard version that came out recently?
Yep, Monstratus.
Yeah. I was like, this sounds familiar.
It's not only Baby Metal, it's also Route of Resistance, so a lot of things that you might know.
Yeah,
it's
Baby
actually
Metal got kind of popular recently.
When I first heard this, I remember thinking, this guitar sounds a lot like Dragon Force, and then I found out that they were actually involved in the making of that. Makes sense now. Interesting combination.
And there's the what I believe to be Black Rock Shooter background for
it
some reason.
It is, in fact, Black Rock Shooter, yep. I think
haven't
that's fine
it,
because
still recognize it.
Oh, we see a no fade from Shirelia. Seems like they definitely want to warm up a little bit.
You know, I reckon that the Black Rock Shooter background is actually perfect because, you know, you see in the background that combination of towers, you know, the whole image that power metal typically evokes, but then you've got the anime character to go with the Japanese vocals. I think it's perfect for the song, really.
Yeah, the song fits a little bit like the scene of, like, getting away of a situation that you just have. Like, it's like showing the backside. I don't know. It's I will probably tell that better in Spanish.
Aw, some very nice tracks being banned out here. Assuming the Gao being banned isn't that much of a surprise.
Alright, well, with the four bans done and done, we will be moving on to the first pick from Argentina. What do you guys think we're gonna start off with here?
I will say Nomad, but Hard
Rock
is also
pretty...
I will say Eastward, maybe.
I was
maybe
just
even
thinking that.
Da-da-da.
Opening with Da-da-da-da is a bit risky, I reckon.
Can we just go like all out, just straight up all out and start off with Noi?
Yeah, if that would really set the tone for the match, no, wouldn't it?
What will we get? What will we get?
They're definitely spending some time considering it.
Legend is V.
Oh! Alright.
Normal as well, but another one. And I like this song.
Well, we were half right.
Okay, so since we've seen this get picked up, I'm now expecting Avalon Eastward to get picked up.
That's how the pattern works.
The
right?
Legend continues.
Yep. They've been picked up.
Well, with you here, Juan, I'm pretty sure we won't have any problems getting the pattern to work.
You just tell me what map you want to be picked, and I will make my work.
Noi. Pick Noi. Even better, William Tell. I doubt we'll see that, though.
Hey, I did that in 7-key workout. We were talking with Halogen, like, about if they pick this, we will flip. They pick this, we flip. That's what happened. But right now, with Legends going to be the opening pick here, selected by the South American team. It is Argentina against Indonesia over here, and we are about to start, which is probably the closer match that we will see for this semifinals. Two teams that are pretty much at the same level, facing in the winner's bracket. Force Red Spellbreak against Solar Beam, Dika, and Deceitful. And I hope you guys are ready because we are about to start with the first map then.
So, final predictions.
Oh, we didn't do any of that. I will say Argentina 6-4.
Right,
I reckon Indonesia 6-4.
I guess we've got some 6-4 hype going on. Okay. I see that you guys kind of actually respect the lovely 6-1 tradition we've got going on here. Nice to know that. See how it is.
Alright, so far, a lot of action drops over here. Solar Beam is the only one keeping the 100%, but combo-wise, there's absolutely no difference here. Accuracy edge in favor of
Indonesia.
Funny
that you mentioned Solar Beam, Juan, because there's no SSs remaining on the board.
Oh, that's a drop by him.
Funny you mentioned Solar Beam.
Right. Juan, anything to add to
that?
Yeah,
I can add that accuracy-wise, this map has a lot of things. No one is actually holding a really good accuracy. Deceitful, only with a 99.60. Every single other player is behind 99.3%. So accuracy-wise, it's a really hard map, but every single player is keeping their combo up. Indonesia is not giving up the chance to come back here. Still half of the map remaining. And one miss from Argentina can be decisive, but they're just refusing to miss. Even when they drop a lot of droplets, it's not making a big deal on that.
Yeah, the droplets themselves won't actually cause that much of an
issue. Oh, both missing!
What's
Solar Beam and Red!
Are those misses. Now, Solar Beam actually missed with his combo was already a little bit low, so the miss from Red is gonna hurt a lot more than Solar Beam.
Oh, the
Steel on
but
that's gonna hurt the most.
That is gonna hurt a lot.
That definitely hurts. That probably
right
is
at the end
if
of the
Argentina
map too.
Just survive. That's
yeah,
it.
That's all she wrote. That is all she wrote. And hate to say that double break pretty much ended it for Indonesia there. But
oh, Velberg with a miss. There we go. The Velberg because of curse.
Not
of
happy with that last miss.
But still,
doesn't matter.
Argentina doing the right pick here, getting the first point. Indonesia will need a good answer here with their own. Argentina 1, Indonesia 0 so far. That mess from Deceitful and Deke at the end end up costing way too much. But at the end, even without those misses, I don't think that was enough for beating Argentina here.
Yeah, given El Solarbeam's breaks and the way Force managed to hold on to the end, along with Velbrique, he did have a slight miss at the end, but I don't think it would have really made much of a difference. Nonetheless, but that is first blood to Argentina.
Good start, for Argentina. So let's see what Indonesia will come back with.
So what we will see now from Indonesia, I expect hidden no matter what.
Noi, 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 noi.
That's sure Milky Ice one. Bear.
Hidden in the Ice Bear?
Yeah, I reckon Milky Ice Bear wouldn't be too far off.
My patent allow that. My patent will allow that.
Whoa. Good to mention that I think we didn't mention this one. Whoever wins this match will be in the
No way.
Boom!
No, I got picked, dang.
You called it. But going back to what I was saying, winner of this match gets top 3. So they reserve the sales of part of the prize pool at least.
Yeah, the winner of each of the winner bracket matches, so the winner of this one and the winner of the next one will be guaranteed top 3. Which is definitely something to work for.
I do know that Force played this map so many times, but I don't know if that's worth to point out, because at the end in tournaments it doesn't matter how much you train, it just matters the try that you will get on it. In this moment, in this situation, roster is not changing for Argentina, but Indonesia is going to replace Deka with Dragon.
Yeah, this map among the hidden picks, it was actually brought up quite a bit. It only has 3 hidden FCs in all of history, really, and it's mostly because of the ending. Around 800 combo, you'll see some really, difficult patterns show up. They're quite messy on CTB, really. And some
definitely
people
hard
call
to
it luck based, but yeah, especially when you throw on hidden, it's just, it's bloody torture is what it is.
Seems like Dante will be replacing here Reds at the end. I'm not sure about Forrest here, because he's not a hidden specialist at all. I was expecting more like Coliron, perhaps, playing on this one, but...
Is Coliron online, though?
Yeah, she is. But maybe they just don't want to use that card right now, going with Force.
Well, you did mention Force
Dante
was playing this map a lot, so perhaps he's staying in because of that.
Makes sense, yeah. But this is mostly about the end. If you can keep up until the end and you don't fail at the end, that's pretty much all the thing that you have to do.
Yeah, you make it to the end and then you just try to hold the highest combo you can and pray, pretty much.
And survive.
Okay, it's so easy to screw up at the end. It's far too easy.
Yeah, we've already seen a few players definitely struggle towards the end of this map.
Can't really blame them. I mean, this map has been around for many years. B2B, one of the really older mappers, and it still only has 3 hidden FCs. That really does say something. Oh,
yeah,
but Force and D-Dragon, both with really early misses.
At the exact same spot.
It's interesting because this map is obviously designed for standard, but
Very much so.
When you play on standard, is actually not all that bad. It's just translate really horribly to Cage of the Beat.
Yeah, it's really not a CTB map.
Yeah, like the BTB end was really horrible for Sketch.
Hard section by everyone. Slower section, but here we go. We're moving into a slightly faster one now.
Okay, here's the point. We're entering second half of the map, and Dante with a miss on that.
What
jump.
Was that?
A little bit.
That is a really bad miss for Argentina.
Now we get a huge boost to the Indonesian side, and now it's all in Belperk hands and Force as well. If Indonesia
I reckon if those two probably take
this point.
Now there we go. There's that miss from D Dragon. They needed it so bad right before slow section. You can tell by the movement that Dragon isn't happy with that at all. There's still two FCs to only one on the Argentinian side, but Dante's combo is higher than D-Dragon's right now, and the gap is really not that much. We're moving into the final chorus, or rather the one right before it. We haven't quite gotten to the crazy section yet, but it's coming.
It's about to start, and the difference is not too high, so a miss can potentially change some, but Force missing just before, and there you have it. D-Dragon with the miss, Belper with the miss, Dante,
everybody
every single
breaks.
Player is dropping. They have to survive. They are looking for it. They did survive. Every single player is alive, but Solar Beam.
I think that's all true for Argentina unless somebody fails.
Oh, Force failed. Or failed. Dante failed. And that's going to be it.
Sliders on similarly old maps, and they are brutal. Because, like, you had to, like, pixel perfect pretty much. It is insane. Like, just doing that without hitting painful enough.
Well, Indonesia did quite obviously win that one, but I'm pretty sure both Force and Dante actually did manage to pass the ending, despite what the stream may show.
Time to check the MP-Link.
No one failed.
They did succeed in passing the map, yeah, but the Indonesia, of course, still got the point. They did hold combo longer.
Yeah, they got the point. 160,000
points of difference. It's funny you mentioned those sliders because Emerald Sword, if you know the map, has something similar on the CTB convert. It's
exact same map with the back and forth sliders.
Yeah, like on CTB, it's hell, really.
Yeah, like you have to be pixel perfect to get the start of that map. It's actually insane. I can't imagine trying to do that with Hidden. Anyway, with that, we will be moving on to Argentina's second pick. Now, it's actually pretty close because it's already one apiece, so if we're to follow how the matches have been progressing so far, where they get the next point wins.
So, now in 1-1 situation, Argentina will probably try to offer another Nomad. I don't see why they shouldn't.
Yeah, it looks like they did in fact pick Story of the Legendary Sword. Oh, there it is. Yep.
Maintaining the 100% pick rate so far. 5 out of 5.
That is actually quite an achievement. I mean, as a mapper, that's a bit of a prideful moment there.
We had something similar last weekend, I believe.
Was it with Atale or something?
Oh,
or was Atale round of 16? I don't remember.
Okay, it wasn't quarterfinals. Yeah, there we go, Atale. Round of 16. Every single team picked it until Mexico decided that they wanted to ban it.
Special snowflake boys, every time.
I know it. There's
always
one. I was so salty.
Yeah, it's like you're just this close to getting that 100%, and then somebody's just be like, you know what? Nope, 97 it is.
Because it was the second last match. It was the seventh match, and then it's like, no. Bad match. We don't want to play it. I was so mad. but like
while we're waiting like... on go on.
I was gonna say we haven't actually had like a we didn't have like a super popular pick like that last weekend. I think the closest was probably just five picks, which I think would have been Avalanche. Yeah, Avalanche was the closest last weekend with five picks. Which is still, over half the matches, so that's not too bad.
A decent, eh?
Okay, we're ready with the third map. Already started. A little bit of a slide intro here. No misses from anyone in these jump sections. But things just started. This is a short map, so one miss is definitely going to hurt more than any other pick. Especially as it is on the middle section. It's going to be really hard to recover from a miss in the middle. And with Reds over here, replacing Dante once again, and Dika replacing Solar Beam. Oh, Belbrick and Reds both finding a miss over there. That was a weird one.
Very odd misses there. And considering this is Argentina's pick, that is not something they can afford on a map as short as this.
Definitely not. Now it's all on Force hands if they want to come back a little bit. A miss from Deke is something that they were looking for.
That could help
for
them on their way. Yep.
Not enough. Deceitful is refusing to give that lead to Argentina, and the Dragon is doing pretty much the same thing. Half of way of the map in, and they're still holding the combo. Reds and Belpricks are hunting down the comeback potential with their combos, building him up as well. But if we don't see a miss from Dragon or Deceitful, this is not going to change at all. There's no way that Argentina can came back with this score disadvantage and combo disadvantage, so they need at least one more miss from either Deceitful or the Dragon, and it's not looking to happen just before the break.
I wouldn't call this a break, it's just a slower section.
Yeah, I think the time for Indonesia to miss pretty much over. The map is drawing to a close, and at this point, Argentina are going to need something short of a miracle to win. I don't see it happening. The Dragon finally missed. It's just not enough, though. There's no time. Deceitful's holding it off force. Dika's combos
is
coming back up.
I don't know if they have so much time. I don't think they
have. Close. It's close. It's getting.
It won't happen. Or it will happen. A miss from Reski.
Will it be? No, it won't. I don't think it's enough.
And Reds, if Reds did fail at the end, I'm not sure what will happen otherwise.
Reds failed, but even if he hadn't, he only had 598,000 points. Indonesia won by 617,000, so they've sort of been 19,000 short. Yeah.
That's a 20,000
deceitful score. Check out deceitful score. Good God.
Just 1 million,
perfect.
You know? Exactly 1
nice.
Million.
That is a very nice SS from him. Force not doing too bad either. Just missing that SS. One droplet, maybe two. Actually, more like three or four, judging by the 250 point difference. But very nice FCs from both of them. That fail from Retz, despite that, as Deadbeat did mention,
the point difference would still have been around 20,000. I will say that
without
that fail, they will still won. Argentina will still won because not failing means that you did not combo break, and that means more points. So
I do see your point there, but
I don't
going
know
on
if,
raw
if
point,
it was enough,
it
but
wouldn't have.
Yeah, I mean, there's no point on arguing up that anyways, like, he did fail, it's not going to change. And right now, Indonesia had the break point that they were looking for, really good position for them, and I'm thinking about what they should go for right now. I'm not too sure.
I mean,
definitely hidden, but not sure what. I mean, which one.
I think if we want to continue the 6-1 hype, I think it's safe to say that Indonesia's won.
Oh, yeah. Only chance for a 6-1 right here is Indonesia's winning, so...
Let's see what happens.
Let's see what happens, indeed. Calafina is going to be the pick here for Indonesia. Solar Beam entering and Galaxy as well, which makes a lot of sense, I guess, with this Calafina pick.
I believe I know what map they're talking about.
pretty sure it's double time.
One bleeds.
What?
Look at what the title of the song is. But yeah, after, did you pick up on what I said, or not?
I did not quite catch that, no.
I said I believe I know what map they're talking about.
Oh, I believe I did catch that, thanks very much.
I don't think Wine did, though, which is the problem.
That's so bad.
You weren't here when Zetra was here, though. That was bad.
I can imagine. Oh, good God. Full hidden all around from Indonesia. Just one from Argentina. Valper K.
I can't see this going well for them.
Reds is having a little bit of issues with this double time pick. Seems finding a miss just in the first 10 nodes in the first big droplets.
Yeah, I mean, based on the mod selections, I wouldn't say Argentina. Remember, this is Indonesia's pick. They did just score a breakpoint. That 6-1 might not be as far off as it might have seemed at the start. But of course, it's far too early to make any assumptions. That early miss from Retz could mean absolutely nothing. Despite the DT, it's not the shortest map in the world. Nobody else having any issues, and Retz has brought his combo back up as well. SS is all across the board, in fact. But the map hasn't quite come into its own yet. Oh, I spoke too soon. Force followed
and
up Shirelli
and Galaxy.
Galaxy.
Oh, Force once
Force
again,
again
with a miss. Reds now
followed
finding
by
a miss.
Reds this time. The Velfer veterans on each side now the only one sticking to it. Al Solar Beam and Velper K.
They couldn't capitalize any lead on that, but Solar Beam finding a miss over there. That will give a lead to Argentina if they can keep up their combos a little bit. But perfect with a miss. Oh my god, this
Force
is so close.
Force has got a decently high combo though. Galaxy's just ahead of him on that, but it's between El Solar Beam's got a really nice combo as well. Going into three digits now, he's the one of only three people. Retz just brought
Force
his backup as well.
Miss.
Oh, never mind.
Shirelli as well. Solar Beam and Galaxy are building up. There's non-players on Argentina's side
Galaxy's
keeping the combo up, but Solar Beam and Galaxy
nice
missing Retz as well. Shirelli with another miss, and the scores are just not that far away. There's 50,000
map to go. If anybody holds a decent combo now, they will shift the map in their team's favor. And it's Force who's just charging ahead desperately. He's the only one with the 200 combo on the board. Galaxy and Solar Beam, who missed at the same spot on the same combo. Indonesia just barely ahead. Now Force can change all of that if he just sticks to it. Plenty of map left to go. Not a lot of combo to
they
go around
more
here.
Than that. They need more than Force right here. Galaxy and Solar Beam has pretty much the same combo that Force does have, only like 100 difference, not too much. They need more
the
than
twin
that.
Celestials to break. They need them to break, but Force is
they
just
need
holding
Belprick
up.
Or Reds to keep up. Not
Reds.
Sure if that will be enough. Solar Beam with a miss
there
over
we go.
There.
The
that keeps
goes out. It's down to Galaxy now. Right oh.
But Belper and Reds finding miss once again, and Force still holding it, and Galaxy as well. This is a 1v1 battle, but it is two. Solar Beam and Shirelli are still finding misses. Argentina is trying to catch up, but they cannot. Galaxy is refusing that chance, and the map is about to end. The scores are closing each other.
And that's it.
And
that's
Force
all
finally
Shiro.
Getting a miss. That definitely means everything, and that means that Indonesia will end up taking the third point at the end
Galaxy
in a really intense battle.
That is unbelievable. Galaxy pulling ahead for his team when they needed it the most. That is amazing. What a man. And Force, he really tried his best. You can't blame him for that. Good heavens.
6-1 hype looking good.
The score difference may tell you otherwise, but that was incredibly intense. Right up to the final 5 seconds. goodness.
At the end, Galaxy and Solarbeam both beating the dual team of Force and Belperk in the double time. Shirelli and Dreads pretty much had the same issues, both of them.
Yeah, very similar scores on there, and very, very similar scores. Just about 54 difference between them. Goodness.
Yep.
I'm interested if Argentina is going to go back to no mod.
I reckon they are going to need to go to their backup plan here if they had one, because that break point, and furthermore, the point to Indonesia has really cost them. They're 2 points down. Indonesia's 3 points away from winning. Argentina do need to get back into the game right now. It's funny because Juan actually mentioned at the start of this match that Indonesia might have had the stronger team turnout here. And that partnership between Galaxy and El Solarbeam, as we saw, was just enough to outdo Force despite all his best efforts. So really, you see that teamwork coming into action there. Even though Galaxy was all alone at the end, if it wasn't for Solarbeam, that wouldn't have mattered, really.
So yeah, it looks like, as you can see, we are going to be going to some Hard Rock, actually, with some Coffin.
Preparing for the funeral already, I see. That's bold.
I was thinking of, like, the graves of Doug or something, but I couldn't think of anything concrete to go with it, so...
Well, going for the backup plan, going for the Hard Rock makes sense at this point, because you need to get back into the game. Using one of your cards is definitely this the point where you have to.
Yeah, when you're behind, there's no point holding on to any secret strat, any really, like, we can win this. It's like, no, you're behind. If you lose here, you're going down. Well, I suppose if they lose, they're not out. So, I mean, I guess they can afford to hide, like, a few things if they really want to, but you wouldn't really want to at this point.
I reckon if they actually want to win the match, allowing the other team to build momentum is really not a good idea. So I think you really do want to bring out your cards as early as possible. You know, bend and break. Don't let them get in too much of an edge. Otherwise, you'll find yourself on the back foot, and it's not easy to come back if you're down by 3 or 4 points. So getting it in early is a pretty decent strategy, in my opinion.
There's also the fact that, as we're talking about, even if they do lose here, they only go down to the lower bracket. But if they do win, they guarantee top three, which is definitely something you
want
to work
towards. And if they lose, they face China or France, I guess.
Oh, and again, we see that three-way hidden from Indonesia, just one from Argentina. It didn't quite work out for them on the pass. I mean, they did win by a decent amount in the end, so it wasn't really the hidden that made the difference, but I don't know. Maybe it'll matter more here. We'll see.
I can see the catcher fits, and that means the CS is too little.
6.5?
Yeah, I think. This is probably the riskier pick of the Hard Rock bracket. 6.5.
Yeah, it's 6.5. Yeah. I remember, because there was a map I was playing where it was CS6 no mod, so when you put on Hard Rock, the catcher was about the size of a single pixel, and it was just like, what am I even doing?
Well, so far, first miss go for Reds here in the Argentinian side, giving even a better lead to the Indonesian side, which not only with three hiddens, is also pulling that combo lead.
Yeah, Reds unfortunately seems to have caught that whole early bird disease, but I don't think missing's the way to get to the worm right here. I think it's hiding in one of the apples.
Okay, there we go. Now as with map, it actually starts. Shirelia with the miss over there, giving Argentina a little bit of a breathe over there, trying to catch up. Shirelia having a little bit of issues reading that section, but the Seafaller and Solarbeam is just destroying it. Red's finding another miss from the Argentinian side, not going to help at all. And now it's Deceitful and Solarbeam carrying this lead further. If they do not miss, they will take this point again. But a miss from Force, that probably will seal the deal at all for Argentina. And Indonesia, with double full combo from Solarbeam and Deceitful, will end up taking the point. I'm pretty sure Reds did fail this map as well.
at the end.
Yeah, Rex is not coming back. His health bar is not going back up. I think he's pretty much failed out. Oh, that was not a good map for Argentina. Score going to 4-1 now. Will the 6-1 be real?
The 6-1 is real. The 6-1 is real.
Is it just me, or there are 4 points of difference between Deceitful and Belperk?
Good heavens, yeah, you're right.
Oh.
How did that happen?
4 points can be a thing in tournaments. You can win by 4 points.
Apparently it
is.
Good God.
Well, that happened.
Yes, it did.
No, even Locker is just like, oh, we can't do 6-1 again. Rigged.
Okay, I will say this was a great pick. It was too risky, but they definitely needed something else, so. Now
well,
let's
I
see
mean,
what Indonesia
it,
decides
it
to go
work
for.
It for them, though. Because now Indonesia have a pick, and if they take it, which they're likely to, they're going to be on match point, and Argentina is going to be severely on the back foot now.
Yep, and they have Piven still, so Indonesia still has probably 3 points in their favor.
That is a very good point. There are still hidden maps available for Indonesia there. Yeah, it's not looking good for Argentina right now. It's really not looking good.
This is Argentina. No, it's Indonesia's pick here, so Indonesia could still go to Milky Ice Beer or William Tell.
Please pick William Tell, please.
Yes!
Oh,
Milky
it's
Milky Ice Beer! My stats continue!
Well, according to environmentalists, in a few more years we won't have any more of those, so it's good to see them while they last, I suppose.
Hey then. What a surprise.
I guess you could say the Fed just melted away.
Cute polar bear.
Must have been a tasty puddle then.
Oh, I'm sorry, my
cute polar bear indeed. Oh, why do you think I am? El Solar Beam's calling choke part, but they're pretty far in the lead right now. I'm not quite sure what's going on there.
Oh, Connor and his run joining there.
Oh, he's here. Oh, yeah, that's good for Argentina, I reckon.
Well, if she performs good, that's definitely good. I mean, I know she was practicing yesterday a lot, so I'm not too sure why she didn't play the last hidden pick. But let's see how she performs here in this one.
I reckon on that last hidden pick, you mentioned Force had been playing it a lot. Maybe they wanted to get the benefit of the experience. Considering Noi is slightly luck-based, playing that pattern a few more times might have given them a slight edge. It didn't quite work, but, well, they pulled in Kali this one, so...
It is a
trying
thing.
A different gear, I suppose.
Tournament nerves are a thing for Argentina, sadly, for the team. Like, a lot of new players, Reds, Dante, Calderon, are playing for the first time. I'm not sure if Velperk played too much tournaments either.
He's played
not
one,
mentioned
at least.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying that he's not skilled at all. Like, definitely, they are the demands to watch for the team, Belperk and Force. But Force has that thing of tournament experience that definitely benefits Argentina a lot.
Yeah, that does actually come into effect. You don't often see it because in the higher brackets of a tournament, typically you'll have the more experienced players coming out. But as you mentioned, Argentina do have a lot of newer faces this year. I wonder how the hard rock to hidden transition will work out here for both teams, because the approach rate is vastly different, not to mention the circle size. That transition can be a bit tricky to manage sometimes. At the best of times, it's a bit unsettling. Here, it could be catastrophic. We'll just have to find out. There we go. Dante and Calderon both dropping early. Not good signs for Argentina. They need to take this one, but D-Dragon following it up on the Indonesian side with a miss, so perhaps not quite out of the running just yet. Solar Beam, Deceitful, and Velperk still holding on. Calderon does drop again. It's a very short map. You can see it's already a quarter of the way over. This is do or die for Argentina right now. That miss from Calderon will not help matters. Solar Beam breaks. Oh, but so does Dante. So that advantage they had for the slightest of seconds is gone. D-Dragon breaks again along with Calderon. If Deceitful breaks, then Argentina can and will take this, but oh,
depends,
man.
Deceitful and Velperk at this point. No one is able to keep up this low AR transition between Hard Rock and Hidden. And Deceitful is really to keep the 100%, yeah. And it's about Deceitful and Belperk. It's the only difference here. And Bolt missing at this exact same spot.
Good Bolt God, how close this is.
Exact same spot. This still can go anywhere, but Calderon finding a fail over there. Definitely not going to help. She needs to build up that combo and that HP bar. Dante and Solar being keep struggling. Belperk and Deceitful are catching up once again, but not too. There's not too much map left. And Belperk finding another miss that will probably seal the deal once again in favor of Indonesia. Dante's not even able to keep up this. Same for Calderon. And the Dragon and Solar Beam, despite not doing their best either, Solar Beam is still holding 100%, but he fails, so watch out with that. He needs to recover from it. And he's not recovering. He finds another miss. And he's not recovering. Argentina survives until the end. This might be it. Solar Beam and Calderon and Dante.
Dante's
failing. No way. That happened.
Check the MP link.
Dante did fail at the end. I'm
pretty
sure about
that. Indonesia.
Yeah, I knew it. If
Dante hadn't failed, if Dante hadn't failed, it would have been just enough. Goodness.
Not
well, by about 20,000, but
yep.
Dang.
Blockhead is so mad that people have missed the song up.
I reckon the Hard Rock to Hidden transition might have had something to do with that. You go from CS 6.5 AR 9.8 to CS 4 AR. It's a big transition. I mean, even the grizzled veterans, Belperk and Deceitful, couldn't quite hold on to it. They sort of lost their heads near the end. Couldn't hang on to the combos.
Okay. I think we need to look at this. It's 5-1.
Yep.
The curse today is...
Is actually going to go to 6-1.
It's still gonna happen because it's Argentina's pick, so it can go to a 6-2 potentially.
Yeah, okay, so this is Argentina's pick. Oh man, they're gonna have to think really hard about this one. What would they go for here? I actually don't know.
Just spin the bottle and see which mod it lands on.
Just press F2
RNG.
And see whatever you want.
Time for some RNG, lads. Oh, okay, we're gonna RNG.
Spectator map.
This should be good.
This is no mod, isn't it?
Yep.
God, this song gives me nightmares. The Angel Honey standard version is hell at some points.
I have not played the standard version of this. You need to link me this so I can fail it later.
will do.
Excellent.
And here we go, the 7th and potentially final map of this match. This is the an average length song, so about 3 minutes in there.
Yeah, I mean, this is...
And it's quite a lively song as well, not many slow sections. It does get a bit faster at some points, but outside of that, it's, I can see jumps being present throughout the map, really. Especially considering it's Spectator, he's not likely to let chances like that slip by.
Yeah, I mean, this is pretty easy to play for here. Indonesia is either going to take it now 6-1, or Argentina...
Again, an early miss from Rhett's, and he's about 100 combo behind. This is a running gag with him now. It's the... third or fourth map in a row where he's done this. It's really not working out well for Argentina. Although it must be said, it's not entirely all him. four SSs across the board right now. Three of them, however, are on the Indonesian side of the board, which is not good news for the boys in blue on the other end.
This is still looking pretty close. I mean,
everybody ever holding through the... Oh, I spoke too soon. Felper K, of all people, has dropped, and that is just devastating for Argentina. Going into the break, you can see... Everybody can see the scores now, I think. And you've got Deceitful and Dika holding SSs, with Force the only one able to hold it together on the Argentinian side. And he's seen the scores. He's got to know. The pressure's got to be on him. Juan did mention that he is accustomed to these nerves, and he can probably work through them, but... Well, Retz has also brought back his combo now, so Force isn't going without support. He's not alone on this. And knowing Velper K, he's not going to drop for a while yet, so it's down to... Ooh, Dika's broken. Galaxy is still holding a full combo, though, and Deceitful still, of course, with the SS.
It is more
so
about Retz
either
than
one of them
else.
Break.
But Galaxy,
and I don't think it's going to be Deceitful, so they're going to need Galaxy to break in order to be able to take a stand here. But, oh, there it is! Galaxy's broken! Now it's Deceitful against Force, and Retz and Velper K both have higher combos than their counterparts. This could be the chance for Argentina to take back some points here. Just, what, 30,000 points here? 20, it's decreasing fast. Last third of the map.
We got it.
This could be the break point that they need. Argentina is in the lead for the first time in the last four maps. Is this the start of a new age? The 6-1 dream could be dead right here.
No.
I'm fine with that.
6-1 dream, please.
It's happening right now. Force still with an SS. Look at him go. Deceitful not holding the SS anymore, but he's still got a full combo. In case Force screws up, he's there to pull it back for his team. Always the veteran. Always the consummate professional. But now it's Retz.
That miss from
early
Force.
Miss or not, he's brought it back. Force has missed. But Retz is there with the 4-digit combo to hold it together for Argentina. That 200,000 point lead. Deceitful can't make it up by himself. The map is about to be over, and Argentina are going to make this 5-2, aren't they?
Definitely.
It's happening, boys.
If they
is
don't
happening.
Fail at the end, which I don't think will happen, it ends up happening.
Come on, no slip-ups at the end, no fails, not this time, not this
it
time.
Happen. It won't happen.
Argentina are back in it. Well, they've got a lot of ground to do, but got to start somewhere, right?
It definitely has to 5-2. Happen. I mean, it definitely has to start somewhere if you want to make it.
Anyway, rip the 6-1 then, I guess. It's finally been broken. I gotta be honest, I'm kind of sad now. I mean, I guess I can't be too sad because I did kind of want Indonesia... I was favoring Indonesia to win this one, and they are still in the lead, so I shouldn't be too sad, but... It really would have been kind of cool to see that 6-1 continue.
And just like that, things could be looking up. It is Indonesia's pick, though. Remember, Argentina are by no means out of the woods yet. They've got a lot of points to make up here.
Yeah, but it's Indonesia's
pick. Indonesia's still on match point, and depending on what they pick, they've still got a hidden, haven't they? William Tell is still available.
It's a bit of a stretch looking for that one. I mean, no one's really picked it so far. It's not... really something we can think about it. I mean, yeah, we could get picked up, that's certainly true, but I wouldn't count on it too much.
Yeah, as Penn mentioned, the curse is broken. It's not the day of 6-1s.
So... any other ideas outside of William Tell?
Indonesia taking some time for their next map selection, as they should, really, because it is match point. Ah, there we go. They have decided to go with the final hidden.
Oh,
William Tell over here.
Oh, yes. I'm okay with
this. This map is... it's interesting.
I will say something about this map.
It is actually a creation of Louis Cipher, or Lucifer as he's more properly known, an ancient standard mapper who loves to use high velocity sliders in his rather quirky mapping style. The thing about this song is it speeds up as you continue to play. It starts out decently slow, and then near the end, it gets faster and faster, and the jumps, of course, which are full screen jumps, they go faster and faster as well. And on CTB in particular, that's really something you've got to watch, because if you're not expecting it, it just creeps up on you and just... Oh, okay, so not a good look. With the old performance point system, which of course valued those full screen jumps very highly, this was quite a popular map to try in full combo, just for that extra boost it would give to your rank.
Juan, what were you going to say?
With hidden though, those jumps can be very, pardon the pun, very deceitful. You don't quite expect them to be where they are. And with hidden, of course, once you miss, it's very easy to screw up.
Whoa. I'm not sure if Arf is hearing me. Are you hearing me, Arf? No, he's not hearing me. Okay, it doesn't matter. What I was saying, this is not the song that I would like to see end this match. Definitely not.
And here we go.
Yeah, I'll actually be really surprised if Indonesia wins on this. I mean, it's the first time we've seen this, so... It'll definitely be kind of cool to see Indonesia win off this, but... It does seem like a lot of people are having trouble
with this. This is all across the board right now, even Deceitful not able to hold it together. If there was a lot of people on this current squad who would be able to pull off this map, it would be either Velpercay or Deceitful.
I mean, we've seen a lot of people, I wouldn't say comfort zone, but
they're really some of the people you'd expect to be able to play this. Good God, look at those combos. Nobody can do this properly.
Yep. I feel like a lot of people are having trouble on, like, Milky Ice Bear. This looks like even more trouble.
Velpercay holding on to a very handy 3-2 combo for Argentina right now. It's not very far in the lead, but it's much higher than what anybody else has got right now, so that is really important. We're moving into the final section of this map now, too, so really... Oh, man, Argentina... Everybody on the Argentinian side has higher combo than Indonesia. This last hidden pick really didn't quite work out as well for them as they'd hoped. Well, the combos are all gone now, but the damage is done. The map is over. Well, almost over. There we go. And with that...
Is this the comeback?
5-3.
Is this the comeback?
So much for the sweep. Indonesia being given a run for their money here. Having, I wouldn't say dominated, but pretty much done extremely well on all the hidden picks so far. That one is... probably the most far out hidden pick in the entire pool. So yeah, Argentina right now. And look at that. Go nuts, chat. Come on. This is the time. Don't let Indonesia hog all the glory. Make them fight for it.
Okay, so yeah, that is going to take it to 3-5 as we said earlier, so this is now going to be Argentina's pick, I believe. So yeah, they're making a pretty impressive comeback here. I did actually think this was going to be kind of like a 6-1 continuing on from the train we were kind of running earlier, but if this keeps up, we might actually end up in a tiebreaker, which would definitely be pretty cool. But for now, it looks like we are actually going to be going to Avalon, which is a no more. Yeah, so this is kind of something I was expecting Argentina to go back and pick up earlier. One of these kind of like a no more Matt. But looks like we are actually going to be joined with Detroit again. Welcome back, man.
Hello, and how is everybody doing?
Not bad.
Yeah, this seems to be quite a crazy match going on. Indonesia looked like they had it in the bag, but Argentina is not letting it go. The 6-1 curse is broken, and we could possibly see tiebreaker hype.
Yeah, I mean, if we actually see tiebreaker here, that'd be really incredible.
Indeed.
Do you think we might see a tiebreaker here? I did.
It is a possibility. I mean, if they were all the way back to the corner with only 1 point and managed to come this far, they seem to be going for that tiebreaker.
I really have no idea how this is going to end up now.
It could be possible. Who knows here? We're going to find out with Avalon Nooka here that's going to be played next. It's the overdose difficulty. And we've seen this quite a bit so far this weekend. I really feel like Argentina might have a chance here, but Deceitful is playing as well as Giga and Galaxy. This could be hard. This is their final swan song at this point. Yeah, unfortunately, Juan, you do sound quite quiet at the moment, so we will we'll just assume that you said some really good stuff, and we will continue to move on.
Ooh.
We do see quite a few drops from Indonesia's side already, so that's going to give that early lead off to Argentina.
Okay, I should sound fine now. Okay.
Yeah, there you go.
Alright, so let's see what do we have over here. Noma selected by Argentina here, and this is their last chance. If they win this one, Indonesia will be only one match point. I mean, if they lose one more pick, it will be a tiebreaker. So, really important situation here by both teams. Argentina is a little bit on the lead so far with Force, Combo, and Velperk. Red is doing a really good job as well. Dika's finding another miss over there. Not going to help Indonesia at all. Third of the map already in, and Dika's still finding misses. Galaxy Deceitful are trying their best to pull that out and keep it, but they are not doing so well as a team together in order to keep that lead up.
You are correct, Juan. Dika has had quite a few problems here moving on to this. It must be incredibly frustrating for Indonesia as a team to be this close to victory and then have to battle it out so hard. But Argentina is not letting this go. Reds did drop right now, but that is
and Deceitful.
Yeah, they're slipping like bananas here. There's no way to cap them all. The only one here that's still got their combo is Force, and Force drops them as well.
Anymore. But there's no more combos, and Argentina has a really big lead now. It's all about surviving at the end. And if they do, they will be 5-4 in the downside.
Very much so. Argentina really making this comeback, the first match of this day.
It's still not done yet. They need to survive.
As long as they can survive this last section, which they did, pretty sure that's going to make it 4-5 here. They only need one more point, and we will see a tiebreaker.
What is even going on? Did not expect.
So, this might be the comeback here for Argentina. They just need one more pick, and they will take into the tiebreaker situation. They need to win this pick by Indonesia.
Yeah, I mean, Indonesia really need to be careful with what they pick. This is their last chance to pick something. And if they don't pick well, they get the tiebreaker.
This is absolutely insane. Not unprecedented, though. We have seen crazy comebacks like this before.
You know what? I can tell you one. Finals of last year's CWC between Indonesia and Chile. Chile coming back and Indonesia winning the tiebreaker. That is the first one that comes to mind.
Yeah, this is going to be nuts.
Oh man, this pick is going to be so important. Indonesia is taking their time in order to select it because they have no more hidden remainings. And Argentina's momentum is building up, so they need to pick smartly. Double time is probably the one that makes more sense for Indonesia here, but I wonder which one.
I still don't know what the gurgle here. I mean, we've got Eastwood open, Da-da-da open. Hungarian dance number 5 in G minor. Green, green dance, and the other hard rock I can't quite pronounce. So there are a few options, but not that many.
Green, green.
Oh, okay.
That sounds like double time, right?
Yeah, double time.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I was kind of hoping for Eastwood, but I can remember this.
This makes so much sense. Indonesia really needed to go for the double time, which is probably the point where Argentina needs a little bit more luck in order to win it. So nice choice here by Indonesia. Let's see if it ends up working up or if Argentina will force.
All right, so Zitro, what are you going to say here? Are you going to go for the 6-4 or are you going to go for the tiebreaker?
Well, it's very clear that Argentina wants to take this to tiebreaker. They fought back incredibly hard to this point. If we don't see a tiebreaker, it is an incredibly well-fought match by Argentina here. But Indonesia cannot just let this go. They can't say that it's in the bag here. As if they slip up, they are going to have to go over for the tiebreaker, and that could be anyone's game.
Yeah, I really have no idea what's gonna happen here. I mean, I really hope Indonesia can get the point here. I really do, but I'm feeling the Indonesian win less and less as this goes on. I really just don't know anymore. Oh. Felter K saying he forgot hidden. That might be a problem. Either way, it looks like the one guy with hidden though will be El Solbeam and Galaxy. What was it, sorry, one?
I'm not sure if they can restart, but it's not going to matter anyways. They already started.
It looks like El Solbeam actually dropped. The same with Deceitful, not something they want to do so early in the map. This is the long version of the song, so they have a little bit of time. Reds is also going to drop twice there, Force and Velper K holding their combos. Galaxy doing well, El Solbeam starting to bring their combo back. The same with Deceitful. This one is going to be the one that decides it here, folks. Are we seeing a tiebreaker or are we going to see a defeat? Right now, as things look, Argentina does have the slight lead, but
they're
not
cutting
much
down. Solarbeam and Galaxy with double miss and Bulber K as well. Only the Deceitful now with a great combo for Indonesia, but Force is negating the possibility of a comeback. And Reds also is doing their job, keeping that combo up. And as
I think
soon
it's
as
probably
fog,
a good thing
breaks.
I think it's a good thing they didn't go for Hungarian dance number 5, because otherwise this probably would have been finished by now.
Deceitful is just going ham here. He's just destroying the map. And the match is so close at this point that I don't even want to talk. Galaxy finding a miss over there.
It's going to be a tiebreaker.
I don't know. Yeah. We can talk that early. And miss can definitely ruin everything here. Deceitful is regaining that chance. Force as well doing his best. Bellbreak and Reds building the combo up. Galaxy is the only one a little bit far away. And there's only 200,000 points of difference here. Argentina is doing their best to force the dream, to make the dream happen. But Bellbreak with a miss, that might give a little bit of an advantage to Indonesia. And with only around 10 seconds remaining of the map, Force is still going ham with a full combo, carrying his team into the victory. Deceitful trying to do his best in order to keep that up with a jump and not going to be enough. Reds is not failing, but Galaxy just decided to give up at the end. And Argentina will be forcing the tiebreaker at the end.
Holy crap. That is tiebreaker hype, guys. That is going to go on.
And we have Arif back. Hello there.
Hello.
Okay, cool. You can still hear us.
That is absolutely crazy. So we are going into Pavor Nocturnus. That is going to be something that has to be played here now. Now, as you guys remember, this is quite a long song. I think it's almost about 6 to 7 minutes of drain time. Real big endurance map here. This one is going to take everything they've got. Will Argentina be able to rise from the ashes and take this victory from behind, or Indonesia? Will they be able to lock in their final point and finally claim the victory they've been fighting so hard for?
Okay, but before we start this match, first chap, I want to see some hype. We need some hype for this match. I want to see some hype.
How can you not be hype in this situation? They went from 5-1 to 5-5. I mean, jeez.
I demand hype.
Be careful. It's scary out
there. We were calling the 6-1, and then they just turned it right around on us. That was beautifully done.
Yep, there it is. Beautiful. Thank you, Twitch chat. Beautiful.
And this is the perfect tiebreaker for it. The Scream Streams, the long version of Pavor Nocturnus, mapped by none other than Kip Torek, Canada's Wonder Boy. What Velper K said right there pretty much sums it up. Even if Argentina can't complete the, comeback, what he said was, even if we lose, what a match. And yeah, he's right. What a match.
This is probably match of the weekend.
Not to mention, we're not even done yet. Germany versus US comes up after this, and you just know that's going to be something to watch as well.
It's been like a quarter of an hour as well.
Yeah, unbelievable way to end it. End the weekend, that is.
Would have been awkward if that match was like 20 minutes ago, though. Guys, we've already started the other match.
Well, don't worry. This isn't the end of this match. We have a few more next weekend as well. Oh, well, next...
Tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yep. My apologies. Okay, I'd forgotten about those as well.
Tomorrow, if I'm correct, we will have South Korea versus Singapore at 1 a.m. UTC, followed by France versus China at 12:30. Thanks. Someone can correct me on that if I'm wrong.
12:30 p.m.
Yeah, I just. I'm leaving at 12:30. I'm definitely going to leave on top there. Just, I'm not sure about the lineups. I'm pretty sure it's South Korea versus China. South Korea versus Singapore and France versus China.
Mm-hmm. Good to have you back, Juan. I don't think you'd have missed this for the world. Glad you're back.
Man, if there's something that I don't want to miss, it's this.
Yeah. Can't miss Indonesia beating Argentina, that's for sure.
Well, we have to wait and see, man.
It's done!
What if they draw? Wouldn't that be something?
I don't know if that can happen.
Well, if it happened in the past, not on a tiebreaker, but...
They would play the tiebreaker again.
Oh, God.
The song is definitely scaring me. I can tell you that.
It's such a perfect tiebreaker. It builds up and then the chorus, if you can even call it that, the explosion of noise is just... immense. It's beautiful. Igor's style of breakcore might take a bit of getting used to if you haven't experienced it before, but once you wrap your mind around it, it's amazing.
A lot of it's just stream heavy from what I know.
It is, yeah. It's an intense stream heavy map.
I think unless it's a CTB map, most eyeballs will probably be kind of easy-ish on CTB. But I think when people start mapping like CTB specific eyeball maps, it's gonna be a lot more challenging.
Yeah, you're definitely onto something there. some of the hardest stream maps in Standard do convert to relatively easy converts on TTB due to the fact that streams by themselves, or in and of themselves, are not a difficult pattern to get used to. But when you map a CTB-specific difficulty for that same song, you're going to add a lot more jump streams in there, things that would give you hell in Standard, but in CTB it's basically like, you know, yeah, this is high-level fruit catching, nothing to see here. Basically a pretty map. God, the pressure is even getting to the players. Belper K taking a quick bathroom break.
Yeah, I'm actually pretty glad I woke up. I almost missed this one, and it got really good and really fast.
You can say that again. We were gearing up for a 6-1. That turnaround came out of nowhere.
Oh yeah, like I was praying for the 6-1 the whole time, and then, nope.
Alright, there we go. We're about to start. This is the end, guys. The end of this match. The last map, Pavor Nocturnus. And whoever wins this one gets top 3.
That being said, in this single day of the week, almost everything out of the map pool has been touched now.
Woo! Yeah. Also, I wonder what mods we're going to see here, if any.
None, probably. Oh, we do see one. Galaxy opting for Hidden on the Indonesian side.
Makes sense, he's mostly a Hidden player, but... this is the time, guys. This is the point where you have to show the support to your own team. Go Argentina, vamos Argentina, or... go Indonesia, and I'm not sure how to pronounce that in Indonesian either, but you guys should know if you support your own team.
Wuk, wuk, wuk.
I just hope that nothing breaks. That's the only thing I want.
All right, and it looks like everything is going pretty good at the moment. Everybody's just enjoying this slowdown section right here.
I'm not.
Well, I'm probably feeling a little bit of tension in the slowdown, but this is the really relaxed part here. This is where you want to build combo. Dropping here would be absolutely detrimental.
Yeah, this map is almost 6 minutes long. As Zetrot did mention earlier, you don't want to break in the slow section, particularly because the once you get to the intense section, oh boy, is it intense. If anything, you pretty much will break there, so keep your combos where you can. You're going to need them. No hints of any damage from either side so far, though playing it very cool. Slight lead from Indonesia's side, a few bananas, I think.
Nah, it's the Hidden from Galaxy, that's a difference.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Accuracy-wise, Argentina is on a lead because DK is not holding 100%, but the Hidden difference here is just being enough for a score point difference in favor of Indonesia. But now we're about to start with the actual map. Relaxed section, calm part is already gone. So let's see how these two teams perform here. Building up a little bit of the hype already, entering into the second quarter of the song.
Yep, that deep-throated singing will now be accompanied by a very powerful backbeat, which will just get stronger and stronger as it continues. Still a bit of build-up. We're not quite at the rough section yet, but it's coming. You can just feel the tension in the air. It's electric. Sparks are almost literally flying right now.
This song is like perfect for a tiebreaker in my opinion.
Oh, Miss from the
It really is. Oh, that is just, of all the people, you would not expect him to break in a place like that. But
he's a tiebreaker master. Usually he's the tiebreaker master.
He's just he has been the most consistent performer on Indonesia's side today. And the tension is getting to him of all people. I mean, you can just imagine how much, and that's really bad for Indonesia because we haven't quite gotten to the rougher section yet, even now. And the three FCs from Argentina just pumping up that score.
It's too early to talk though. There's still a lot of map remaining and score difference. It's getting better and better, of course, but you need to be careful here because a single miss can actually break everything in just a second because combos are so high that just one miss can destroy everything. Second half of the map is already in and we are about to start with the chorus section just after this break.
Oh man, I don't even think I'd want to break at this point. The break's even more scary than the actual gameplay.
It really is. I completely feel you on that.
It's like, oh, where's it going to come from next? No!
Oh man, God, that, I'm just
if
tired
it hadn't
of
been
waiting
for that one break
from
Deceitful. I know exactly how you feel, Juan. That is where the map will be made or be broken, really. If Deceitful hadn't missed, it would have been just that much more important to keep it together. Oh, and here comes the jumpy section.
Here is the part. It's not the harder part yet, but there's
just
a lot of stuff happening. It's getting complex and complex as time goes on, and there's no much map left. Only 200 points of difference in Argentina's favor, and every player is holding the combo here. Belfry being the first one dropping for Argentina. Red Stika and Force. No more full combos instantly for Argentina. This was flicked down to Indonesia's favor in just a second. Galaxy still holding the full combo there. It's going to be more than enough to keep that up. And the combo dream got destroyed just in a second. And Deceitful is pulling that back with 200 combo. And seems
Galaxy
like it's
breaking 2k.
Again, if they keep this up until the end, Galaxy with the hidden performing amazingly and full comboing with no one is able to.
That and single performance, that is unbelievable from Galaxy right there.
The point is just fail or nothing. Miss from Galaxy over there. It's not going to be anything bad for the team because there's no chance for Argentina's coming back here. They don't have time. Even if everyone breaks from the Indonesian side, there's absolutely no chance. It's all about failing, and Galaxy with the hidden is performing well. Deceitful is holding it, Deke as well, and at the end Indonesia will be rising into the top three with Galaxy holding strong enough until the point where everyone was just missing. And despite
you
early disadvantage from Deceitful, they will end up taking it.
Indonesia may have ended up winning, but man, Argentina made them fight for it. What a match.
Argentina probably had them shaking literally in their boots the entire
time.
Yeah. To come all the way from thinking, hey, you know, we've got this in the bag, to, oh crap, we're playing the tiebreaker. That's a large marginal jump.
Yeah, that is just, I mean, the tensions flying, man. That combo from Galaxy, though, that just blows my mind, with hidden no less, to score the highest combo on a tiebreaker. And Deceitful with a one miss as well. We were just completely shocked at that miss because he only won on the board, but he held it together to the end, and that's really what his team needed for him to finish, and boy did he. Can't help but cheer for Argentina, though. I mean, they had a three-way full combo for the longest of times. They brought the match back from 5-1 to 5-5. I mean, they played their heart out. They really played their heart out.
They almost had that one.
Yeah, they almost did. It's not often you see 11 maps played in a best of 11 situation, but we did, and every glorious second of it. It's not a match that's going to be easily forgotten, even as we do move into finals week. The week after, I can't see this leaving my mind for a long time.
All right, and it looks like we're going to be moving on.